flesh and blood. We use this idiom often, isn't it? Looks like Shakespeare was also very fond of this idiom. Do you know why I'm saying this? It's because Shakespeare has used this idiom in many of his plays. Interesting, isn't it? Come, let us know more about this idiom. This idiom has two meanings. One, used to denote a mortal or living person. Not a ghost or something, but a real person. Example, I saw him in flesh and blood, happily enjoying with his friends. Two, used to describe a person who is blood relative. Example, I felt very bad when my own flesh and blood turned against me. It looks like this idiom was much in use during Shakespeare's time, but it was used to indicate the human race in general. It was Shakespeare who gave it a twist and made it refer to a family. In Act 2, Scene 4, King Lear says to his daughters, Regan and Goneril, I, Preeti, daughter, do not make me mad. I will not trouble thee, my child. Farewell. We'll no more meet, no more see one another. But yet thou art my flesh, my blood, my daughter. These powerful words indicate the pain Lear is going through due to the torture inflicted by his dear daughters. These pitiful words of a father who finds it hard to believe that his own daughters, that is, his own flesh and blood, have gone against him, stab the heart of each and every reader. Such is the beauty of Shakespeare's writing. Looks like Shakespeare loved this phrase. He has used it in the following plays. All is well that ends well. Hamlet, Julius Caesar, King Lear, Love's Labor's Lost, The Merchant of Venice, Much Ado About Nothing, Pericles, Richard II, The Tempest, Timon of Athens. So the next time we use this phrase, let us try to remember the great writer Shakespeare, whose works and words bring us so much joy centuries after it was written. Hope you like this segment of Great Words of Great Writers. Let us know your feedback in the comment section and keep listening to Achala, Vismaya, Loka for more of such interesting facts and stories.